Try to imagine a map of your entire body across the brain. The parts of your body that you use the most will have a bigger representation on that map. For example, your eyes, your lips, your tongue, and your fingers will all have a bigger part on this map, as they are used most for sensation and function. Scientists have shown that this map has the ability to change. So for example, in Braille readers, the fingertips have a much bigger representation than in those that don't read Braille. Conversely, in hemiplegia, one side of the body is not used as much, and therefore its representation on this map is much smaller. Research has proven that CIMT has shown an increase in the size of the affected arm on the brain's map, and this increase in size has remained when followed up 6 months later. This shows that CIMT affects not just the physical arm and hand, but actually causes cortical reorganisation in the brain that lasts even after the program is stopped. It is the changes to the brain that allow for the improvements with CIMT to continue long after treatment has been completed. Intensive training of the upper limb during CIMT rewires brain activity and increases the representation of the upper limb in the brain. Constraint-induced movement therapy has been shown to stimulate the brain to form new connections and grow new neurons. This process is called cortical reorganisation, which quite simply put is rewiring of the brain.